Let's dive into a quick history lesson.
Tokenized real-world assets,
RWAs,
will break down everything you need to know about this concept.
But why do we need them?
The market for tokenized real-world assets has just surpassed $10 billion, an incredible milestone in a category that can change how investors approach asset management. But what exactly are tokenized real-world assets, or as we'll call them, RWAs? This is On the Block and will break down everything you need to know about this concept, the key differences between real-world assets and digital assets, and why investors are looking at this new investment opportunity.
Let's dive into a quick history lesson. In 1990, the concept of digitizing real-world assets began to take shape with the creation of financial instruments like real estate investments, trusts, REITs, and exchange-traded funds, ETFs. These innovations allowed investors to hold fractional ownership in assets like real estate and commodities, laying the groundwork for future developments in tokenization.
Fast forward to the late 1990s, and e-gold attempted to digitize gold through redeemable certificates. All through its struggle to scale, this effort served as a precursor to what would become next. In 2009, Bitcoin's launch introduced the world to blockchain technology, but it's the Ethereum smart contracts in 2015 which revealed the true potential of tokenization. These advancements enabled decentralized ownership and asset transfers without relying on intermediaries.
However, early attempts like colored coins and Mastercoin on the Bitcoin blockchain and later the DAO on Ethereum in 2016 encountered significant challenges, including security breaches and regulatory issues. Despite these setbacks, these initiatives played a critical role in refining the technology and processes we see today. By 2021, the improved technology and clearer regulations have paved the way for the rise of tokenized real-world assets, a market that has now surpassed $10 billion. But what exactly are RWAs and why do they hold such importance?
Tokenized real-world assets emerge when we take tangible assets such as real estate, commodities, or financial instruments and convert them into digital tokens on a blockchain. This process involves encoding the ownership rights and transaction history of these physical assets into smart contracts and ensuring that each digital token corresponds directly to a real-world counterpart. By doing this, we enable fractional ownership, secure transfers, and access to a transparent, immutable record of each asset's history. But what are the most popular types of tokenized real-world assets? As the market for real-world assets continues to grow, several key categories have emerged, each representing a different segment of this expanding digital frontier.
Private credit dominates nearly 75% of the tokenized real-world assets market, reaching a staggering $8.7 billion as of today. These assets typically include loans or credit agreements that have been tokenized and provide investors with new avenues for access and liquidity. The second largest category, with a market cap of $2 billion, involves the tokenization of the US government debt and allows investors to trade fractions of government bonds with greater ease and efficiency. Commodities, while not the largest, represent almost $1 billion and perhaps stands as the most often cited category. Tokenizing assets like gold, oil, and other natural resources enables these traditionally physical assets to be traded digitally.
Tokenized corporate bonds with a market cap of a bit over $11 million form a smaller but significant segment. These tokens represent debt issued by corporations and could perhaps offer a new way for businesses to raise capital in the digital age. The category of bonds issued by governments outside the United States stands at $10.6 million, provides international investors with easier access to these government securities through tokenization.
However, these amounts remain relatively small. To illustrate, in July 2024, Poland alone, a country I'm from, sold savings bonds worth approximately $3 billion, which is 300 times more than the sum I have just mentioned. These five categories illustrate how real-world assets are being transformed into digital tokens and offering new ways to invest and manage assets. But what makes this transformation possible?
The key lies in the underlying technology that powers real-world assets. Tokenized real-world assets rely on three core technologies that enable their creation and management. Blockchain technology forms the foundation, with Ethereum serving as the most widely used platform. Ethereum's blockchain records every transaction and ownership change and ensures secure and transparent data. Smart contracts on Ethereum, written in a programming language called Solidity, automate the enforcement of these contracts and allow transactions to occur without intermediaries. Developers use the ERC-20 standard on Ethereum to create fungible tokens, such as digital currencies, while the ERC-721 standard supports the creation of non-fungible tokens, which you might know as NFTs, which represent unique assets.
The next crucial component involves asset digitization. Chainlink provides oracles, secure data feeds that connect real-world data to the blockchain, and ensures that each token accurately represents its underlying asset. Tools like Open Zeppelin contracts enable secure deployment of these tokens in compliance with industry standards. Lastly, legal and regulatory frameworks play a vital role in aligning tokenized assets with existing laws and regulations.
For example, consensus diligence conducts audits to verify that smart contracts meet legal standards, while Securitize offers platforms for regulatory compliance, including KYC and anti-money laundering procedures. This is pretty much everything you need to know about the process of creation, management, and trading of tokenized real-world assets. But how do these tokenized assets differ from digital assets like cryptocurrencies or NFTs? The answer is very simple, so I hope you will remember this forever.
Real-world assets are physical or traditional financial assets, like real estate or bonds, that are tokenized on a blockchain so that they can have a digital representation of ownership. Their value is tied to real-world markets, and therefore they require strict legal and regulatory compliance. In contrast, digital assets such as cryptocurrencies and NFTs exist solely in the digital space, with their value derived from digital ecosystems or market demand. They are native to blockchain and often enjoy higher liquidity and fewer regulatory hurdles compared to real-world assets. Essentially, while digital assets are entirely digital and integral to blockchain-based economies, real-world assets bridge physical assets with blockchain technology. But why do we need them? Why can't digital be kept digital and physical physical?
Investors need tokenized real-world assets for better liquidity and easier access to both financial and non-financial assets. This way, they can buy and sell smaller portions, which makes these investments more approachable. Tokenization also opens up global markets and helps investors diversify their portfolios. Let me give you an example. This specific brief from Bain & Company highlights a growing interest among investors, especially the wealthy, in private alternative assets like private equity. However, the current infrastructure for these investments is outdated and lacks the efficiency and scalability needed to make them more accessible.
Tokenized real-world assets offer a solution by lowering investment minimums, increasing liquidity, and automating essential processes like subscription and reporting. By harnessing blockchain and digital standards, tokenized real-world assets could potentially make private markets more accessible, transparent, and efficient. This shift not only meets the rising demand from individual investors, but also allows asset managers to broaden their reach.
Investors interested in real-world assets typically include high net worth and very high net worth individuals, but also institutional investors like pension funds and family offices managing affluent family wealth. These investors are drawn to real-world assets for their potential to provide diversification, steady income, and long-term growth. They can purchase these assets through a variety of channels, such as private equity firms like Blackstone and KKR, wealth management firms including Goldman Sachs and UBS, and specialized tokenization platforms like Securitize and ADDX.
Real estate investment platforms like Fundrise and private market exchanges such as Nasdaq Private Market also offer access to real-world assets. The question now becomes, if it is so easy, then how likely it is for this market to grow? Tokenized real-world assets are likely to continue growing. While predictions like the one from Standard Chartered Bank and BCG envision a 30 trillion market by 2030, more conservative estimates such as Jamie Coates' projection of 1.3 trillion seem more realistic. The growth will likely be driven by increasing adoption in areas like private credit, bonds, and other financial assets.
However, the pace might be slower than some expect, as the tokenization process still needs to prove its advantages over traditional finance systems, and broader infrastructure and regulatory frameworks need to evolve to support this shift as well. If you have enjoyed this episode, please follow us on Spotify and subscribe on YouTube, and be sure to come back next week as we will continue to unpack the latest trends in tokenization and blockchain technology.
That brings us to the end of this episode. Thank you for joining me. Thanks for listening to On the Block.
We are also working on a new explainer series in which we will dive deeper into the world of tokenization, so make sure to click the bell button. Until then,
this is Dominik.
This is Przemysław.
And don't forget to be on the blog to stay ahead.